My name is Brandon Sarkis on behalf of Expert Village. Today I'm going to be showing you how to use Adobe's Lightroom software. And now we're going to discuss keywords. Keywords or keyword tags are a really great way to organize all of your photos. It's a good way to sort through lots and lots and lots of photos. Let's go over here and close all this stuff up, clean it up. And we'll go down to keyword tags and pop that open. And you can see I've got a couple of different keyword tags that I use. Let's go with scene, for example. We'll click on that, and you'll see all the photos I've tagged as scenery photos. You can scroll through and interact with them just like you normally would. Here's my sky photos, kind of more of the same, and iPhoto originals. And what you can do is you can use this to sort out your photos. Actually, here at the bottom, let's go back and touch on this again for a second. This is the painter. This is how you tag them. So you would pick keywords, and you would go and paint, you know, test or whatever, you know, pictures of my dog or someone's name or something like that. Another good thing about these is you can actually use these keyword tags to find certain images. So we're going to click on this here, and we're going to click in our little search box, and I'm going to type, I'll type HDR, and hit return. And well, there's no photos in the selected keyword tag to sort that. So we'll actually close this. We'll back up to our library. We'll open up all of our photographs. So you can see there weren't any in that folder. So we're going to reopen our Find dialog, click on that, and now we'll type in HDR and hit return, and you'll see all the photos tagged HDR pop up, which is pretty nifty. So like I said, here let's type in iPhoto. So all my iPhotos pop up, or iPhoto pictures pop up. So if you had named these like after your dog or after a friend or mom or dad or birthday or something, you could just type that in as long as they were tagged appropriately, and they would pop up even if they weren't in the same catalogs, which is a pretty handy feature if you're trying to sort through a couple thousand photographs at a time.